Well, today we have one of the hottest new pop stars to hit the charts. You can see her on MTV or VH1. Take a look at this video. It's Heather Hunter. It's a dream that I'm dreaming. I want it on and on. You've got it going. Yes, that's Heather Hunter. And again, you can see her videos on VH1 MTV. But Heather, where did you get your start?
Okay. Well, I got my start as a burlesque dancer when I was 18 years old. And then I was spotted by a photographer from Players Magazine to do a centerfold. And I wound up doing the centerfold magazine, and I got on a cover story. Then I started to get very popular, and then I was offered by a producer to do an X-rated adult film, which was One. And then I decided to do it, and when I did One, I enjoyed it, so I decided to sign a contract for about 7 films.
So you ended up doing 7 films? How many films did you do total?
I really ended up doing 16, and 3 are compilations.
16 mm-hmm. films. 16 adult films.
Uh-huh.
16 X-rated videos. Wait a minute, hey. I see 2 guys clapping. All the women are going like this. Oh, wait, just what did you have to do in these adult films?
Everything you do behind your closed doors, you know? And it's really up to you if you want to pop in a VCR tape and, you know, watch it.
And watch it. But now mm-hmm. you're going from porno star.
Exactly.
To pop star.
Mm-hmm.
Some people would say that that's just the wrong message to be sent out here today.
But, you know, some people should say that, you know, what I did in my past career has nothing to reflect on what I have as my talent, which is singing and dancing and art as well.
So you should be looked at as a talented person no matter what she did before.
Exactly.
Does anybody agree? Huh? Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Why'd you take this particular route, and where were your parents when you were 18 that you were burlesque dancing? I don't quite get it.
Well, people have to understand. People think that people who are in the adult industry, parents are coming from abused family, which is not true. I come from a very high respected family. I choose to leave my house when I was a little bit younger, underage, and that was my decision. I was a rebel from start, and that's what I choose to do. And my parents, they probably don't agree to what I do, but they have to accept me. They have to support me because I'm their child. And they love me, and they care about me, and they would like to see me do well no matter what I do, you know?
And so, for a while, you were one of the biggest stars in porn. Is that correct?
Yeah, and I did 16 movies in 2 years, you know, and that's not a lot of films.
Did you say that's not a lot of films?
No, I know girls that do two years, about 150 films, you know? Some do 75, some do 50. It's up to them, you know, it's their choice.
Okay, wait, yes, sir.
Personally, I'd like to compliment you. It was a beautiful transition in a positive direction.
Thank you.
And I just encourage that.
Thanks.
Wait, but you know, the music video that you were just listening to, what's the name of that song?
I want it all night long.
I want it all night long. That's a real, some people might say that that isn't necessarily the most positive direction.
But, you know, it's just the title. You have to understand the song is about a man in my dreams, a man that I can't seem to have. So he's in my dream. He's my fantasy, just like everybody else.
Wait a minute. Heather, if after 16 films you haven't found a man that you wanted?
I still haven't found a good man is hard to find.
A good man is hard to find.
It's really hard to find a good man.
Yes, ma'am.
So true.
Heather, mm-hmm. I want to speak to you. Heather, I'm older than you.
Mm-hmm.
You did 16 adult films,
yes. And
you were into burlesque at 18?
Yes.
I am ashamed of you.
Well, that's
you did adult films, and you have a good voice?
Mm-hmm.
Why did you start singing at 18?
Babe, I've been
I'm a single parent. I could dance. I'm a good dancer.
Okay.
I could do a video, but I don't know VIPs. You should be ashamed of yourself.
Well, that's you.
I'm a mother with a 16-year-old girl.
I bless you. That's your opinion. You have to understand.
Well, but you know, now,
that's your opinion.
You know what, Heather? There are a lot of people out there that kind of have this view, but at least right now, what made you say, I've done enough porno,
but you have to understand, people with this view, I didn't get to where I'm at today listening to what people had to say. You know, I worked very hard to where I'm at now, and I am very blessed of how I got here. Okay?
Well, let me ask you, What happened? You were doing the porno films, and then you said, okay, I think it's time now.
Well, when I got into the business, it was, I got in there as with a plan. You know, I didn't want to make my whole life to be a porn star, adult video star. That wasn't my goal in life. My goal is to get to where I'm at now, which is the music, which is my dancing. I also have a comic book coming out. You know, I'm doing it all. Hey, you know, why not, you know?
Okay, yes, sir.
What was your parents' initial reaction to, you know, your choice? And, you know, how did they react? I just want to know.
They were shocked. They were kind of shocked. At the same time, they knew that I just grew up the way that I wanted to do what I wanted to do, and they accepted it.
How much resistance did you get from the industry? I mean, you have a record deal, I must say. You have a record deal with what company?
Island Records.
Island Records, which is a very, very popular company right now.
Which is Ray Jones' label, yeah.
Major company right now. You have a record deal. Now, there must have been some resistance when you walked in with that first demo, and you said, yeah, I'd like to do a music video, and they said, wait a minute, we've seen enough of you in video, right? Well, what was the reaction? What did they say?
Well, what it was, when I retired from the films, which was about 3 years ago, I got on Soul Train. I did like an appearance on Soul Train, which I wanted to dance on Soul Train. And I got very popular at that, and I left Soul Train. And I did a few talk shows stating that what I wanted to do and what my career, which was singing. And I knocked on a few doors with demo tapes. Some just turned me away. Some did not have faith. They didn't take me serious. And all of a sudden, Island opened that door. They gave me a shot. You know, it took a long time going through the marketing and the promotion, but they realized that I was no joke. I take it very seriously. If you're very persistent and you want what you want, you can get what you want, no matter what you do in your life.
Okay, yes, ma'am.
Hi, I just wanted to ask, did you use condoms?
With the films, you have to understand behind, what a lot of people don't know, in the X-ray adults industry, when we do a scene, we are contracted for AIDS. You have to take your document, you know, to state if you're positive or negative. And during the scene, we use other precautions, which is what I say, Massengill, you know, Naloxone 9. And the contact is so quick, there's no way to transmitting. It was like the safest sex I've had, and the safest sex that I would say a lot of people will have going out to a club and not being aware of what people have.
All right, I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to take a little break, and when we come back, we're going to talk a little bit more to you about what the business was about. And what a lot of people don't know, and it may surprise you, is that Sylvester Stallone, Madonna, Bo Derek, a woman right now named Tracy Lords, all got their start in Hollywood through X-rated films. When we come back, we'll talk about the inside of the X-rated films with Heather Hunter. We'll be back right after this. Former porno queen, I will call you that because that's really the title, you could say X-rated film star, who is now turned pop diva. And I want to go back for a second and talk about your days as a porn star. You know, I did a movie, my first little bit of movie, which was a made-for-TV movie with Perry Mason, and it took us 3 weeks to shoot this thing. Took me, oh, thanks. But the scenes that I was in, it took us probably, each scene, it took at least a full day. Now, when you do a porno movie, do you have to do this all day?
But no.
I mean, you know, I just imagine people for three, God's going to say, look, could you move that over this way? Just a little, you know, what?
If I had to do that all day, I would be tired, just like anyone else. No, what it is some shoots are done in one day, which you call one-day wonders. Some are done in 3 days.
The whole movie is done in one day?
Some are done in 1 day. And if you're shooting on film, it takes about 3 days to 4 days. And just like you are on an R-rated film, which I did Frankenhooker. It was an HBO film.
Frankenhooker?
Yeah.
R-rated, so that's
it
legitimate?
It was R-rated. Okay. It was legitimate. And you sit around, you wait. Basically, you wait till your time comes up, and then when you get up there, you do your dialogue scenes. And the dialogue scene will last for about 10 minutes, and then you do your sex scene, and your sex scene will last about 35 minutes between the cutting and editing, you know, for him, action, cut, turn that way, action, cut, turn this way, you know?
Well, now, you said in your very first movie, like, the dialogue, you only had three words, right?
Well, that's my first movie, because they wasn't sure if I can act. You know, this is like a first movie, and I was nervous, I was anxious, and when doing the sex, that came natural, you know?
Well, I bet it did. Okay. The sex part came natural, but the acting part was a little harder. Then.
If your singing career goes down, do you think you'll ever go back to porno?
See, that's, I'm through with porno, X-rated films.
You go, girl.
I'm really through, you know?
Okay. you're done with the X-rated films.
I'm done with X-rated films. You know, that was something I did in the past. That was just a little hobby that I took on for 2 years. Now,
well, can I ask you, that this little hobby had to pay well. Did it pay well?
I'm comfortable.
I mean, do you get residuals now every time, you know, all these guys that have their hands up go and rent a video? Do you get residuals? Because he's seen you, I think, several times, this guy right here. Yeah, look at him. So what do you think, sir?
I don't know. After 16 movies, I mean, how do you separate work from pleasure? I mean...
You know, that's the funny thing. I'm glad you asked that. Because now, from doing X-rated films, now in my personal life, I can appreciate a man much better. You know, how I feel, how my feelings are different between them two are that my emotions are with the person I'm in a personal relationship with. If I'm doing an X-rated film, there's no emotion to that. You're there to work, you're there to do your thing.
Well,
now, there has been a porn male actor that I had a scene with, and I wind up falling in love with him after that, and we wind up dating for a very long time. It can happen. But usually you're just there, you're there to work, and...
Okay, but wait, if you fell in love with him, how did he accept the fact that, you know, like, next week you had to go do another movie? So he said, wait, you know, I thought you said you were in love with me, and you out with, what's your name?
But, you know...
Chris, you out with Chris! And I saw Chris in action, and I know he's not as good as me! No, I'm only kidding, Chris, I'm sorry. Well, how do you do that, though? How did your boyfriend take that?
Well, the one I was dating in the business, he was handling it fine. I just didn't like it. I didn't like the situation that I couldn't, honestly, when I was in the business, I really didn't have any relationships because I don't believe in having a relationship and also having sex with someone on camera. That doesn't go for me. You know, it was very hard. Now that I'm out of the business, I'm able to get on with my social life and enjoy whoever I'm dating. Right now, I'm seeing someone, you know, that I really care about.
Good. Yes, sir.
Hi, Heather. That was going to be my question. Mm-hmm. Was it hard to maintain a stable relationship
with
someone outside the business?
Really hard. Even if I wanted to, it was basically hard because they'll get intimidated. You know, some will feel...
Inadequate.
Great word.
I'm just throwing it out there. I've never seen your video, but I know that there are people in these movies that will make any man feel inadequate, I guess.
They have to realize I'm just like anyone. I'm just like any female, you know. No matter what I do, you know. I think any woman in this audience could do the same thing I did. I just did it on camera. That's the only difference.
And a lot of them in the audience out there viewing have done the same things you do, but they just didn't do it on camera.
Exactly. So, that's what I'm saying. We
got to take a break. But before I go to break, I have to ask this question: with this current relationship, was this guy that you're going out with now, was he in the business?
No, he isn't.
So, just straight up, as a man, I'm going to ask it. You know, if I was a guy, I mean, you're an attractive woman, but at the same time, be like, you know, gee, you know, Freddie over there saw you last week, and Glenn over there, and every time we go out someplace, some guy walks up and goes, ooh, I just saw your video, can I have it? I'd be like...
But see, my man is very strong, very confident, he has a high self-esteem, and he's a fine-looking man, you know, and, you know, if you're strong, and you confidence in yourself, it don't matter what you do. You know, the person who's on the side of you will be there forever. You know, that's how it is.
Okay, we have to take a break. And before we go to break, I will tell you that Heather has got to leave. She's not going to be with us for the rest of the show because we're going to get into talking to some other porn stars who are trying to make a break into the business in another way. And I will say that because you have an individual contract now and you're working really legitimate now, you have been legitimate for a while, we've decided to just say... Thanks for being here, and
thank
we appreciate you coming for this portion
of
the show.
Thank you for having me.
And good luck to you. We'll be back, and when we come back, we're going to meet some other porn stars who say, hey, we want the same break Heather's got. And maybe we can't get it the same way she got it. We'll be back right after this.